More evidence this morning of the critical staff shortages facing our aged care homes, with two more facilities in rural New South Wales forced to close. To discuss, let's bring in CEO of Southern Cross Care, Helen Emerson. Helen, good morning to you. What has led to this decision to shut down those facilities?
Unfortunately, Carl, we're acutely aware that these are our residents' homes. And first and foremost, I'd like to say that this was not a decision that Southern Cross Care made either lightly or without undue care and consideration. We're very aware of how distressful that this news would be. But as an experienced provider, we've had to make this decision for the longer term interests of our residents. The aged care crisis, the aged care is in crisis. Aged care industry is in crisis. It's a much overused expression. It's been in the news a lot. It was in the news yesterday with Minister Colbeck. But the fact of the matter is it's starkly true. As a registered nurse myself who's worked in the industry for over 30 years, I've never seen it in such dire circumstances.
I have to say this, you've made it darker, haven't you, for those families and for those people who, I don't know where they go, I'll ask that in a second, but that's a hell of a thing to tell someone, they've got to get out of your facility.
It is, Carl. It's as a experienced aged care provider who is in this to care for older Australians, it's one of the toughest things we've ever had to do. But again, I'd say we are suffering from severe workforce shortages, and we cannot hand on heart continue to operate these facilities in the state they are. We need to provide quality care. We want to provide consistent quality care, and without the staff, we cannot do that.
So where do these people go? I mean, basically, for a lot of them, and this is the last place they can go, and you've told them they've got to get out. Where do they go?
So we don't use it in terms of you have to get out. We work extremely closely one-on-one with all of our residents and their families to find suitable alternative accommodation. In the town of Bombala, we've been working with local providers. They've been amazing working with us. They're acutely aware themselves of the struggles. So we'll be working with the families to work out where is the best location for them to move to. What we don't do is we don't put a time frame on this. So we, you know, that has to give the resident some reassurance. We don't say you're out by this day. We work closely with them in a very measured and considered way to ensure that we can find suitable alternative accommodation.
I can't imagine anything worse than having a family member in there and being told you've got to get out at some point. I can't imagine what those emotions would have been like. I guess at the end of the day, you're making that decision.
Look, absolutely. I completely agree. As someone myself who's had relatives in aged care, it's extremely distressing, but it's equally distressing for the residents and the staff to see them work day by day with severe shortages.
Okay. We appreciate your time today, and hopefully it all goes smoothly as it can in those difficult circumstances. Appreciate it.
Okay. Alex. Thanks, Carl.